Good morning, everybody. I'm on my way to work right now, but there's a small problem, and that is that it is 10:53, and my shift started at 10:45. I wasn't late leaving. I didn't wake up late. I left at the same time I leave every day. I am simply stuck in traffic on the turnpike, and I have been stuck in said traffic for about 25 minutes because of an accident way up ahead, and it's driving me insane. What's driving me even more insane is I can't get in touch with anybody from work. I've called dispatch, I've texted my supervisor and the owner, and no one's gotten back to me, so I don't know what happens now. Like, because everybody loads out at the same time, so if I get there after everybody, yeah, my van's still gonna be there, but how am I gonna get my packages, you know? Well, I made it, and when I say I made it, I mean, like, supremely last minute. Our vans, we line up in two lines, B line and C line. I was in C line, which is the second one to go around to the front of the building, and I got there as the B line had finished leaving, so I sprinted to get into my van and get it turned on, and then I got into the C line and made it around. I had to sign in to my work phone and everything on the way around to the front of the building, but I did it! And now I have, how many bags is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, I think 12, 12 bags, and a good amount of overflow. I was in such a rush, I didn't really look at what I had. 146 stops, 225 packages, which is not that bad. Not that bad at all. I don't know why the light isn't on back here. Hang on. If I do this, that's better. So yeah, super last minute, but I made it, and now I can get to work. Technically, you know, I was late to clock in. Get off of there, you stupid bag. I was late to clock in because my shift technically starts at 10:45, but I wasn't late to actually pick everything up, you know? So this is kind of my process. I don't think I've ever really explained it very well. Maybe I have. Just take the first bag, which is the one right by the door over here, the last bag that I'm going to be doing. Oh, you know what? This is probably 13 bags, actually. I think I have one buried under the overflow. This is the last bag. So I kind of work my way this way and then work my way back, at least when I'm in a rental, which is what I'm in today, because it doesn't have shelves. If I had shelves, I would just have the bags on the shelves. So I'll just open up the first one, and then I pretty much just unload the boxes onto that bag that's over here, the last bag. And then, of course, as I work my way down, I get more room to work with. I take the boxes out first, because they take up the majority of the room. And when I've done that, it's literally just, it's just envelopes in there now. That's a lot of envelopes for the first bag. God damn it. All right, I'm gonna be here for a bit, because I try to organize them in a certain way. I'm trying to find one that has the sticker I wanna show you, not covering the address. Okay, so I can sort of show you this. This sticker right here, if it would focus on it. Every bag, every box has one of these. And that tiny number at the bottom, 7526, you order them. That's the number we look for when we're delivering. We don't look for your address. We look for that little number on that little sticker. And they're usually in order, or delivered in order. They are not put in the bag in order. So generally when you open up a new bag, you sort them out, put them in order, and then it's a bit easier to find them, and it speeds up your process a little bit. Because if you're digging through a bag at every stop trying to find the one that you need, it's not great. So, what do I need? Where's my work phone? Where did I put that? Yep, my first one is an envelope. So I'm gonna be here for a little bit.
Yeah, I could not fit the envelopes there, so I had to stack them like this instead. So I'm gonna be leaning over to pick them up, but that's fine. That one I couldn't fit in the line. Why is there so many in this one bag?
So I just knocked out 63 deliveries in like 2 hours and a few minutes, I think. Because I've been in just basically two communities that where everything's like super close by. It's almost the entire top row of bags that is not adjusting. And now it's having me drive 14 minutes up the turnpike I guess I never really looked at my route before I started, never really looked at the map, but I guess because I'm technically on an overtime day today, they probably like took stuff from other people's long routes and made a route for me. So like I'm starting really far away from the station and I'm going back up the turnpike towards the station and I'll end up there, I guess. But the area that I'm going to is the crappy area with all of the long dirt roads. So I'm taking my break. I've done 63 deliveries. I think I deserve a break. So you remember how I said that I was going on the turnpike to get up to my next delivery? I kind of forgot that this is the same section of the turnpike that I was on this morning, where there was huge traffic. I mean, that was because of an accident, and that was like 3 hours ago. Damn near 4 hours ago, actually. It was 4 hours ago. What am I saying? It was 4 hours ago, but there's still all this traffic. Like, what? Why? Why is it still here? How far up does this go? All the way, it's the entire thing. Well, wish I'd remembered that beforehand so I could have avoided the toll road, but here we are.
I made a friend.
Hi. How you doing? How you doing? You're a sweetheart.
I just gave him some treats. I keep some of Minnie's treats in my van now for friendly dogs, not the mean ones.
Well, it's pretty late now. I've not gotten a lot done tonight besides editing some Splatoon episodes. And then I've been in and out of sleep over here. It's 3:30 in the morning, so I'm gonna pass out, hopefully make tomorrow productive, assuming I can wake up at a good time. We'll see, won't we? I've had a good day today. I gotta be honest, I think today went really well. Just in terms of my mood, I've just felt like I've been happy all day. I've actually felt in a really decent mood all day despite not having the greatest route at work. I don't know. I can't complain, though. Cool, good day. Thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.